Hello, my name is Laurent Pertois. I work at Jamf as a senior professional services engineer. I'm based in Paris and I cover the all EMEA region. EMEA stands for Europe, Middle East, India, and Africa, for those who don't know. My role here is to help organizations to ensure they have the proper tools and workflows when it comes to manage macOS and iOS devices. I will help anyone with special needs, whether it's a special workflow or a specific script. I also do a lot of scripts. I've been involved in helping organizations integrating Jamf Pro with other tools such as Azure and many others.
And hello, my name is Micha van der Bent. I work at Jamf as a supervisor consulting engineer based in Amsterdam and also covering the EMEA region. My role at Jamf is to help and train organizations to understand how to manage, deploy, and support Apple devices at any scale, from small businesses to large enterprises. I'm helping where I can, and my goal is to keep it simple and connect the dots and automate what is possible. So today's agenda will be look like we're having setting up our challenge, set the scene. We're going to talk about the tools what we are going to use and how to implement them. And of course, we're going to demo it to you.
And to talk about the challenge, it often happens that companies have difficulties to track all the changes happening with employees. You can think about an employee is leaving the company or is changing departments. And sometimes we need to act upon these changes. So more as a user than a device-oriented approach. Instead of acting based on a request made by HR, that we then decide to send the MDM log command, for example, to all associated devices when someone is leaving, we want to automate this process. And we are going to use Azure and Jamf Pro to avoid some delays and human processes. We've all been through that. An example, which we are going to show you during this presentation, is someone leaves the company, as I said before, and their account is disabled in Azure. Jamf Pro will automatically send an MDM log command to the devices owned by this user.
And what do we need to accomplish this? What tools do we have? Let's look at the building tools. First of all, on the Jamf Pro side, we have the Jamf Pro API. If you don't know Jamf Pro API, there's two parts of it. The classic API we have for a long, long time, and the Jamf Pro API. The classic is old school, being around for a while. And when working with classic, we need to post it in XML, because we cannot use a JSON. And I can say there are no updates to the classic APIs. All updates has been done in the Jamf Pro API. A few Jamf Pro versions ago, we updated the classic API to make use of the bear token, an important security change. So if you didn't have it already, please update your workflows. Come the end of the year, bear token will be the only way to authenticate. Like I said before, with the classic API, you have the ability to post an XML file only, not a JSON file. In the Jamf Pro API, you can use a JSON file to post. So you know about the Jamf Pro API a bit, but where can I find a little bit more resources? Just do a /, and API at the end of your Jamf Pro URL. Here you can find the API documentation. There's a lot of more information found on the developer.jamf.com website, where you can find the references and you can even specify the version. What you also can do is you can download and use the Postman schema for easy testing. And if you are not familiar with Postman, we give examples in different languages like Shell, Swift, Python, and many more.
Now, let's have a look at the built-in tools we can use from Azure in order to do this automation. First, we have the Log Analytics workspace. So a Log Analytics workspace is a kind of unique environment for log data from Azure Monitor and other Azure services such as Microsoft Sentinel and blah, blah, and different tools that Microsoft can offer. Each workspace has its own data repository and configuration, but might combine data from multiple services. Then we have the audit logs. So we use an alert rule to monitor and capture a signal that indicates that something is happening on a specified target. So this is based on the audit logs. The alert rules will capture the signal and check to see if that signal meets the criteria on the conditions. For example, a user account is disabled. If the conditions are met, the alert is triggered, which initiates the associated action groups and updates the state of the alert. Then we have the automation and runbooks. This is where the magic can happen, if you want. The automation account that is going to be used to authenticate the runbook is a managed resource that we can have in Azure Resource Manager or the classic deployment model. One automation account can manage resources across all regions and subscriptions, for example, for a given tenant. You can add a runbook to Azure Automation to either create a new one or importing an existing one from a file or the runbook gallery. You can use PowerShell or Python scripts in runbooks to automate the tasks. We will use PowerShell for the specific needs we have. And where can you get more information? Of course, on the Microsoft website, docs.microsoft.com/Azure. It's a very good starting point. The documentation is very, very, very complete. And you will see a lot of links inside the documentation to the different resources we have. And we will give you links also at the end of this presentation. Now let's talk about the implementation and the automation of everything. So first, we're going to need to create a specific API user in Jamf Pro so that we can use the Jamf Pro API in a secure way. We don't want to use our admin account, obviously, and because that account will need to will be used from Azure to connect to Jamf. Then in Azure, we will create our log analytics workspace, and we will define our audit logs, alert rules, and automation and runbooks again. So the Jamf Pro API user, as I said, we want to have the maximum level of security. We don't want to use our admin account. So we're going to create a specific user for that. And this user will have the minimal privileges that are required in order to do the task we want. So first, in the Jamf Pro server objects, when you create a Jamf Pro API user, you can go to the, you're going to make it you're not going to make it with one of these predefined templates like admin or read-only. Then we will go to the privileges, and in Jamf Pro server objects, you're going to look at the lines called users, and you're going to check only the read column. Then you go to Jamf Pro server actions, and we're going to need two actions: send computer remote log command and send mobile device remote log command. We will provide you a link to a documentation about the API privileges that are required for each endpoint mappings that we're going to use. Then we will go to Azure. And the first things we're going to do is create a log analytics workspace. As I said, this is a way to gather logs and automations together. And we're going to add the audit logs to the log analytics workspace so that later it can be analyzed by the alert rule we will create. And this is mainly we use this to have a cost center, for example, for audit log analysis. This is not uncommon in large companies to have different cost center depending on what you want to do. And then the audit logs, as I mentioned, in Azure AD is a bit like the big fire hose from which we can get information. Everything that happens in Azure AD will go to the audit logs. So we're going to filter that. And so we can see changes that are made to users and groups in Azure AD because they will be logged. So using the logs analytics workspace, as we discussed before, we will be able to filter the content based on specific actions, such as disable account. And in Azure ID, we need to send the audit logs to the log analytics workspace that we have created using the diagnostic settings. So we go to the Azure ID and then the diagnostic settings, and you will see audit logs, and we'll send it to the specific log analytics workspace we've created at the previous step. You will see it in the list. And the alert rules. This is where all the filter happens. So the alert rules will read the data from the audit logs that is sent to the logs analytics workspace, and will use a specific query. And that query will extract the relevant information we need. And in our case, the query is to find all users that are disabled and extract their UPN, the user principal name. These two informations will be used later to execute a script in the automation account as a runbook. And as you may see on the screen, we really only extract the information we're going to need. We don't keep all the information from the audit logs. And with these informations, we will avoid extra requests to Jamf Pro, we will be able to get information, from Jamf Pro to see who is which devices this user has, is it whether a Mac or an Apple mobile device, and we will be able to log them. And finally, we need to create a runbook to execute a script that will use the Jamf Pro Classic API to log the devices, as Maisha explained to you. This script will use the UPN that was extracted from the alert rules, as we've just seen. And with that information, it will first connect to Jamf Pro Classic API using the specific users that we created, the Jamf Pro API user. It will go to the user's endpoint of the Jamf Pro Classic API. And if that user is known from Jamf Pro, we will be able to see which devices are associated with that user in Jamf Pro in the inventory. And once we have this, we can extract the Jamf ID of each devices and send them an MDM lock command using either the mobile device commands or the command endpoint for the Mac. The runbook is run, as I said, by an automation account, and we will also integrate with Azure Key Vault in order to protect the data from the Jamf Pro user. Misha, this is your turn.
Now let's explore how the workflow works in more detail by detail each step that allows us to achieve our goal. In Azure, an action occurred, like leaving staff member's account is disabled. This action will be reported in the audit logs. With the log analytics, we can look at the logs and monitor any event that are happening, like disabled users. Here we see that in the audit logs, we in fact search for a specific operation with the value disabled account. For this specific action, we also extract the user principal name as a string, and we export three informations: date and time, activity name, and UPN. We can use this to retrieve the users from the log analytics, to check if there are devices associated to the users. This is the script mentioned privileges that is run by the automation account as a runbook. The beginning we don't see is to acquire the bear token to talk to the API. It's using Azure's Key Vault, like Laurent said before, to store credentials securely. In the highlighted item of the script, we can see that we use the list of UPN provided by the alert rule. In the order to query Jamf Pro and to extract a list of mobile devices that are linked to that user in that specific example. Once we have received the list of devices that are associated, the last part of the runbook will send an API command to all of the mobile devices of the users that was disabled using. In this case, using the Jamf Pro API to send the MDM lost or lock command. And once the command is sent, the device will be put in lock mode, like here.
So now let's see that demo in action. So as we said, someone is leaving the company and then the account of that person is disabled. So that means an action happens in Azure. When that action happens, we will be able to find it in the audit logs. So it goes to the audit logs first, and then the log analytics workspace will get these audit logs and click. And then because of the log analytics, we have the alert rules, if you remember. It will find that action, find the disabled account, and we'll execute the runbook. And the runbook will say, hey, Jamf Pro, can you please lock all these devices because they can't be used anymore. And Jamf Pro will execute that command using MDM, of course. And here we see a Jamf, the iPhone is locked or put in lost mode, which basically means the same for the user, can't use it anymore. So let's do a quick recap of what we've discussed. We had a challenge. Challenge was things are happening in the company that we are not always aware of, and we need to have action based on what is happening. So we can't do it manually. Let's try to automate. We discussed the built-in tools. We have two kinds of built-in tools. We have the Jamf Pro API that we can use, and we have Azure. And Azure offers a lot of built-in tools. I'm not going to name them again. We've discussed them a lot. Then we looked at the implementation of this automation workflow that we discussed, and how we have a full automation of someone is disabled and the device is locked automatically. All the devices that of these users are locked automatically. And we had a quick demo. And now, as we promised, we're going to give you a link to all the resources. You will find on this page, you will find the resources with the links to the documentation, to specific documentations. We will give you a script, the script that we used in the runbook, so that you can have a look at it and maybe adapt it to your needs. And you can find it at jamf.it/JNUC1067. That's the number of this session. And you can use this fancy QR code that Misha created to get to that link.
Well, I want to say thank you being here, seeing our presentation, and I hope it triggered your mind, because this is really a powerful tool to use in your environment if you have Azure on your side. But don't be fixed to Azure. If you have Okta, other workflows methods where you can use, you can be creative here with the API. And this is just an example that something happens by the user, we can perform an action outside of Jamf, let other tools talk to Jamf. So I hope you enjoyed it. Have fun with the rest of the presentations we have in JNUC, and hope to see you next year.